Have you ever been wondering what type of employment you should choose? Did you think about the PAYE, maybe more secure and longer job? Or you were thinking about the freelance position to have more freedom and more money as well? In today's video, I will cover a few ways you can actually work in construction in UK, and at the end, I'm going to tell you which one to choose. So the first type of employment would be the PAYE, which is pay as you earn. This is, I would say, a normal employment. When you are employed full time, you're gonna have a 24 days, probably holidays, plus bank holidays sometimes. And this is what I would say, it's probably the more secure type of employment. And you're probably gonna be working longer for the one company if you employ it this way. But I think actually, despite all pros, you shouldn't actually go for it as your first choice. The second type of employment is going to be self-employed, and this is going to go under the construction industry scheme. And that will be actually the way, guys, to do your freelance job as an engineer. So maybe just to compare this against PAYE, you're going to have, guys, more freedom. And what I mean by that, you're going to be actually able to change jobs more often. You can actually choose the job you want to work for. And if you don't like a particular job, if you don't like to work with some people, you can actually finish your job. And this is typically maybe a matter of 1 week notice, and no one should say anything bad about it, as this is normal for construction industry while you're working as a self-employed. And that's what I would recommend as well, that you're going to work for a few companies, you're going to compare them, and actually if you're going to find a company you want to work for, you're going to find good people, you're going to probably eventually end up as PAYE anyway. So there's no point to go straight away to PAYE if you don't have to. And now the most important thing, if you actually work as a freelance engineer, you're going to actually earn more money. And this might be actually quite big difference between PAYE and self-employed, as I know engineers, 19-year-olds, 20-year-old engineers, they're actually making 240, 250 a day. So that's crazy money, guys, compared to PAYE, little money, especially when you're starting. So only freelance job, only self-employed position gives you the chance to just learn quickly on one job, jump on the other job, get your experience, and then go for full setting out engineer position. Another good thing for the self-employed, for the freelance engineers, guys, you can actually take as much holiday as you want. Obviously, you're not going to be paid for it, but compared to PAYE, where you got 20-something days off, that's a maximum you can take, and there is no discussion about it. In most cases, you cannot take more. Especially if this is busy, guys, when you want your holiday, it's not even easy to get them when you want it. And obviously, for self-employed, when it's very busy, it's not easy to go away, but you are free, guys, so you can always go. And the worst-case scenario, you can look for something else later, so it's not a big problem. While as a PAYE, you probably don't have to give a 1 month notice. Another way of being employed here in UK in construction is a limited company. It's the way I actually work, but this is more and more difficult now, so I wouldn't recommend this, as after the new rules like IR35 came into power, it's more difficult now. Most companies cannot really employ you through your limited company, as you're going to be treated by HMRC as an employee, so that would be the problem for them, and they would have to pay more tax. And also you yourself, you have to be very careful, as if you're going to be employed by the small company, in this case you might be actually the one to pay that extra tax, so we have to be very careful, and that's why I don't really recommend these times using the limited company. So guys, I think you already know which one I recommend for you, and it might maybe look a little bit difficult for the graduates. Remember, guys, that finding the good graduate program is not that easy as well, and as a self-employed you can keep looking for the junior engineer, assistant engineer position, and when you're still young, you don't have many responsibilities, you can be, and it's even better to be more flexible. And of course the money is the key as well, and as I said, self-employed will bring you more money in the pocket 100%. So I'm going to quickly show you the HMRC pages when you can register for self-employed, and then you can also register or call for CIS registration. And obviously I'm going to leave the links below, so if you want to have a look at this, or if you want to maybe register now, just click the links. So let's have a look at this now. So as you can see, that's the government page here, HMRC, that the register for self-assessment, and that would be actually the first step for you to register for self-employed. So you'd use probably this link here, and then step by step is very easy. You don't need anyone to show you this. You can register for self-assessment, and I'm going to show you now the other link I'm going to leave below. What you must do as a construction industry scheme subcontractor. So you're going to be actually working in this case as a subcontractor under the CIS scheme as a self-employed, but that's going to be your freelance job, and that's going to give you freedom, guys, and probably more experience and definitely better money. So let's have a look here. So very similar to the last one, you just need to register for construction industry scheme. You're gonna click that link and they're gonna tell you actually step by step what to do. And as you can see here, under CIS, a contractor must deduct 20% from your payment. So that's what's gonna be taken from your payment and all the rest is gonna go to your pocket. And in case you didn't register for CIS, 30% of your wages is gonna be taken. Obviously, at the end of the year, if you overpay the tax, you're gonna be paid back, but you don't want a 1/3 of your payment just taken straight away. So I think that'll be all in today's video. If you got any questions, just leave the comments below, guys. And as always, I'm gonna reply as soon as possible. And as you can see, my opinion is to actually try to go for self-employed, be the freelance engineer, try to work for different companies, different job. Working as a self-employed actually gives you this opportunity. No one gonna be asking questions why, as this is normal in this industry, guys. Obviously, it's not like a legal advice or something like that. The decision is yours. You still need to think about your work, what you want to do, about all pros and cons, and then decide for yourself. So thank you again for watching, guys. If you like this video, just leave the thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel. There's gonna be more and more videos coming out. So see you next time.